Amy Pasha and you're watching Good News Today. This week we're bringing you all the color and festivities from a state that comes to a standstill during Durga Puja. You've guessed it right, we're talking about West Bengal. First up, the story of the royal family of Kasim Bazar in Murshidabad. Legend has it that the tradition of community puja was first started by Raja Harinath in 1824, who organized a grand ceremony inside his ancestral home. Almost 300 years later, Durga Puja is still celebrated with the same pomp and show in Kasim Bazar, with family members flying in from different parts of the world to welcome the mother goddess.
Kasim Bazar Rajbari stands for tradition and beauty of all that is old. Established in 1740, this is one of the oldest zamindar families in Bengal. Durga Puja in this house is followed according to both Vedic and Sattvic rituals, while Yagna is done following Tantric tradition. Far away from the glitz and glamour of Kolkata's big pujas, this one exudes old world charm of bygone era.
ছোটবেলা থেকে বাড়িতে এসেছি আমি 13 বছর বয়সে এসেছি তখন বলি হতো তো বলির সময় খুব জোর ঢাক বাজতো হতো যে কি হচ্ছে তো তখন এত ভিড় হতো এবং আমরা পর্দানুষীন ছিলাম তো দেখতে পেতাম না যে কি হচ্ছে কিন্তু আমার ধারণা ছিল বলি হয় যখন তখন বোধহয় একটা আওয়াজ হয় যে ওটা কাটার কিন্তু সত্যি করে সেরকম তো কোনো আওয়াজ হয় না এরকম একটা প্রায় শিশু তখন আমি কিশোরী মনে এরকম একটা ভয় লাগতো এটা এখন ভাবলে একটা মজার ব্যাপার মনে হয় পরবর্তীকালে অবশ্য বলি বন্ধ হয়ে যায় বাবা এটা বন্ধ করে দিয়েছিলেন
বাপ ঠাকুর দাদা থেকে আরম্ভ করে আমি তিন পুরুষ ধরে আমরা এই রাজবাড়ির সঙ্গে জড়িত আমি 22 বছর ধরে আমি এখানে দুর্গা পূজায় লিপ্ত আছি এবং প্রতিটি নিয়ম নিষ্ঠা এবং তিথি অনুযায়ী এই পুজো হয়ে আসছে
Royals of Kasim Bazar Rajbari till date maintains all that rituals followed by their forefathers. Goddess Durga's Vahan is a combination of horse and lion, while Mahisasur sports a green body. They also worship Kumaris on Saptami, Ashtami and Navami, unlike all others who do it only on Ashtami. The unique characteristics of this puja remains the main attraction even for the gen next of this family.
আমি এখান থেকে ছোটবেলা থেকে এসে যাচ্ছি এটাই পুজো বলতে আমি এটাকে এনজয় করি আসলে এবং কলকাতার ভিড় ভাট্টা সব দেখি আমার খুব একটা ভালো লাগে না তাই আমার এখানে আমার নিজের বাড়িতে পুজো হয় সেটা আমি অনেক এনজয় করি
Folklore claims that goddess Durga comes to visit her father's home during this time and therefore it's a time for friends and family to come together. Royals have maintained that too. No matter what, all the members are always present here at Murshidabad during this festive season to pray and worship Ma Durga.
আমার সময় পর্যন্ত নিশ্চয়ই আমি তো জানি যে আমি করে যেতে পারবই এবং আমি যে দেখছি যে ভবিষ্যৎ প্রজন্ম এরাও অত্যন্ত উৎসাহী এই ব্যাপারে এবং আমার দৃঢ় বিশ্বাস যে এরা সবাই চালিয়ে যাবে
With Vinod Patel from Murshidabad, West Bengal, Utkarsh Singh for Headlines Today.
Traditional Bengali families believe that Durga Puja cannot begin without sex workers offering dust from their doorstep for making the idol. Yet for decades, the women of Sonaghachi, Kolkata's red light district, have been denied permission of organizing their own puja. The go-ahead finally came in last year, and this year the women have left no stones unturned in organizing a grand celebration. Manogya Loiwal with their story.
Home to 10,000 sex workers, Sonaghachi is the biggest red light area in Asia. Tradition dictates that Durga Puja is incomplete till a prostitute gives the soil from a home for the idol. Yet, these girls were not allowed to attend the celebrations. They wanted to organize their own puja. Last year, after a bitter court battle, for the second time this year, Durbar of Sonaghachi has organized this puja.
চার পাঁচটা পুজো অলরেডি দুর্গা মহিলা সমন্বয় কমিটি প্রত্যেকে মানে ওটাকে উদ্বোধন করা হয়েছে কিন্তু 5 বছর আগে এটা তো আমরা কোনোদিন ভাবিনি মানে কোনোদিনই না এবং মেয়েরা অনেক সময় আমাদের গতবারে যিনি উদ্বোধন করেছিল মঞ্জু পাত্র 92 বছরের মহিলা তিনি হাওয়াকে পেয়ে দিয়েছিলেন মিডিয়ার কাছে যে আমি 92 বছর বয়সে জীবনের প্রথম আজকে আনন্দ পেলাম কেন আমার খুব মনে আছে আমি যখন 22 বছরে ছিলাম তখন অঞ্জলির দিকে ছিলাম অষ্টমীতে আমার হাতের থেকে থালা ফেলে দেওয়া হয়েছিল তুমি যৌনকর্মী অঞ্জলি দিতে পারবে না সেই পূজো আজকে আমার মেয়েরা করছে, এটা আমি খুব খুশি, মানে খুব খুশি হয়েছিল।
There was a time when they were considered as untouchable. Shunned away from the society, they would turn bitter and lose hope. Today, they worship Ma Durga openly and with great enthusiasm.
তো আমরা বিভিন্ন জায়গায় পুজো দিতে গিয়ে যেটা আমাদের মানে দেখতে পারতো না অচ্ছুদ, মানে আমরা মানে রঙ্গি ভঙ্গি দেখে আমাদের নিজেদেরও খুব খারাপ লাগতো। তার জন্যই আমরা এখানে যেমনি আমরা এটা আলোচনা করলাম অফিসে, অফিস থেকে আলোচনা করে সিদ্ধান্ত করে তখন আমরা যদি নিজেরাই যদি মানে পুজোটা করি তাহলে আমাদের সব মেয়েরাও আসবে। আমরা তখন কিছু জায়গায় সার্ভে করলাম, সার্ভে করার পরে মেয়েরা বললো কি যে দিদি আপনারা যদি আমরা সবাই কিছু পয়সা দিয়ে যদি আমরা নিজেরা পুজোটা করি তাহলে ভালোভাবে আমরা মাকে মালাও পরাতে পারবো, পুজো টুজোও দিতে পারবো। তো যেহেতু এখানে আমরা পুজো করছি, আর দিদি তো আগে বলেই গেল কিন্তু আগে আমাদের আগের বছরে খুব বাধা বিঘ্ন এসেছিলো, সেখান থেকে চ্যালেঞ্জ করে জায়গাটা আসা হয়েছে। আগামী দিনে আমরা চেষ্টা করছি যাতে বাইরেই পুজোটা হয়।
এই যে আমাদের কাছে স্বপ্নের মতো লাগছে, কারণ আজ থেকে বহু বছর আগে থেকে মানে অঞ্জলি কাকে বলতো প্রসাদ, যেটা আমরা বলি যেটা প্রসাদটা মানে পেতামই তো না, চোখেই দেখতে পেতাম না, অঞ্জলি তো অনেক পরের কথা। তো যেটা আমরা নিজেরাই পুজো করছি এবং নিজেদের পুজো করার পরে আমরা বুঝতে পারছি যে আনন্দটা আমাদের কাছে অনেক মানে খুব ভালো লাগছে, সেটা মানে বলা যাবে না, মুখের ভাষায় প্রকাশ করা যাবে না।
Girls forget their dark life and celebrate puja days with energy and uninhibited fun. They perform on their own and entertain themselves. This Durga Puja in central Kolkata is a celebration of different nature. It gives these girls a reason to smile and cherish life without the label of their profession. Manogya Loiwal from Kolkata for Headlines Today.
Every year, residents' welfare associations compete with each other to put up the most beautiful pandal in town. A lot of care is taken and money spent in decorating the idol of Goddess Durga and the pandals. But it's not just religious celebrations. Social issues are also weaved in as themes to make these celebrations more meaningful.
Puja in Kolkata is not only the time of joy and merriment and pandal hopping, but also an opportunity to make artistic statement about relevant causes. Modiali Club of South Kolkata wanted to create an awareness for natural products. Thousands of mushrooms and leaves were dried and painted to decorate the pandal. Seeds of hybrid grass were used to adorn the walls. Together, the outer facade of the pandal took the shape of a crown with a traditional Durga idol of 18 feet height sitting at its heart.
जो हम मानते हैं पर्सनली कि दुनिया का सबसे बेहतरीन इंस्टॉलेशन आर्ट का नमूना प्रदर्शन दुर्गा पूजा है। यहाँ पे देखिए मशरूम से किया हुआ है, घास से किया हुआ है, लीव से किया हुआ है। तो वहाँ पे जब जाते तो ऐसे ही ऐसे जो प्रदर्शन जो मिलता है ये कहीं नहीं मिलता है। तो एक समय है ये 10 महीने 8 महीने एक एक आर्टिस्ट बैठ के ये बनाता है सिर्फ 5 दिन के लिए।
दिस पूजा कमेटी इन कोलकाता चेतला एरिया वांटेड टू सेलिब्रेट वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट। द स्ट्रक्चर एट द गेट ऑफ द पंडाल डिपिक्ट एन एम्पावर्ड वुमन ऑन द लैडर्स। देयर आर मेन स्टैंडिंग बिहाइंड हर। ऑर्गेनाइजर्स हैव यूज्ड 2000 लैडर्स and around 2500 aluminium plates to artistically convey their message.
Basically, हमारा जो थीम है ये साल का वो है वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट, और हमारी जो सीएम है वेस्ट बंगाल की श्रीमती ममता बनर्जी, तो वो भी उनको भी लेके एक चीज़ किया गया है हमारे की वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट एंड मास सेलिब्रेशन को लेके।
Tibetans continue to fight for their land. We have been their friend and supporter in this fight. Indo-Tibetan friendship takes a beautiful rendition in this pandal, where Goddess Durga resembles Avalokiteshvara of Tibetan Buddhism. The clay idol of Durga with 7 heads and 70 hands looks like an artifact for its metallic finish. The pandal resembles Tibetan mass. It's a reminder of Lhasa in the middle of City of Joy.
देख सकते हैं जो मूल मंडप है उसका आधार जो है वो काल भैरव का है, और ये जो मटेरियल है जिस यूज़ किया गया है वो फाइबर है, और फाइबर के ऊपर फॉयल यूज़ किया है और ये जो पूरा एम्बियंस दिख रहा है वो जैसे टिबेट में पहाड़ में आप देखते हैं मन्नत मांगने के लिए लाल कपड़ा और घंटा लगाया जाता है, बिल्कुल वैसे ये पूरा माहौल जैसा है वो वहाँ का माहौल बनाया गया है।
मनोज्ञा लोईवाल इन कोलकाता फॉर हेडलाइंस टुडे।
Now the ambitious plan to dot Hyderabad city with CCTV cameras is still pending. The Big Brother will now be able to watch with the help of traffic policemen who will be sporting cameras on their wrists. The move will not only help keep a check on the policemen but also help in the surveillance of the city. Ratnika Sharma with this report.
At the Saifabad traffic intersection, Chandrasekhar Reddy looks like any other traffic inspector in Hyderabad. But only he knows he's under watch, thanks to this remote watch that is strapped on his wrist. This watch, with a 4G technology device embedded in the camera that is fixed to his pocket and a memory card, ensures everything he does, both live audio and video, is being watched by the control room.
100% control. అది మనకి నేను చూసినా చూడపోయినా ఈ కెమెరా చూస్తాను. సో ఎవరు కూడా అప్డేట్ చేయరు. చేయడానికి మాక్సిమం 90% వాళ్ళు ఇంటెన్షన్ లేదు. ఎవరు 1% తీసుకున్నా కానీ ఇప్పుడు ఆ ఛాన్స్ లేదు, ఆ ఛాన్స్ కూడా లేదు. దానివల్ల కొంచెం తీసుకోవాలనుకునే వాళ్ళు కొంచెం భయం, అది హ్యాపీ మాకు కూడా. ఎందుకంటే మేము చూడపోయినా కానీ కెమెరా చూస్తున్న ఒక భయంతోనే ఫస్ట్ ఏంటంటే వాళ్ళు చేసినా కానీ ఫీల్డ్ ఆఫీసర్ మాకు పడుతుంది ఎఫెక్ట్. సో అది మాకు ఉపయోగం, ఇది విషయం కూడా మాకు ఉపయోగం.
The watch has been given to 20 traffic inspectors in the city so far.
Anybody, this we can also see, public can also see every transaction, whatever they talk to public, whatever they do is entirely recorded. So the allegations of misbehavior definitely will come down.
Citizens feel the fear of Big Brother watching will keep the traffic policemen under check.
Acha hai. हाँ, लोगों के लिए अच्छा है. कैम बोले तो उनको धंधा कम होता.
अच्छा,
कम होता कैसा था भी कम होता.
इट्स अ रियली गुड आइडिया बिकॉज क्राइम रेट विल बी कंट्रोल्ड एंड सो मेनी ट्रैफिक कॉन्स्टेबल्स ऑल्सो दे विल बी इन कंट्रोल, दे विल नॉट टेक ब्राइब ऑल्सो.
Traffic constables demanding money on the side by traffic violators or citizens bribing them to avoid paying a hefty fine is commonplace. What these cameras strapped on their bodies will do is to keep an eye on them 24/7, something that could prevent petty corruption. With camera person Damodar, Ratnika Sharma in Hyderabad for Headlines Today.
Now, we've all loved the seaplane from the famous cartoon series Tailspin, but that was a cargo plane. In a first of its kind service in Mumbai, seaplanes are introduced for travelling pilgrims to Shirdi. Sakhi Deshpande with this report.
I've packed my bags and I'm ready to go. But I'm not leaving on a jet plane, I'm leaving on a seaplane. That's right, I'm sitting on a seaplane, a one-of-its-kind service that started from Mumbai to nearby locations, tourist destinations and pilgrimages. One of the routes that started a month ago was to Pavna Lake, Pavna Dam near Lonavala. And the one that I'm on board right now is to Mula Dam near the very famous pilgrimage of Shirdi. This seaplane service has opened up the Mumbai traveller to a faster, quicker way of getting to nearby locations. While by road, Mumbai to Shirdi takes almost 6 hours, this amphibian aircraft will touch down at Mula Dam, which is 70 kilometers away from Shirdi, in just 45 minutes. The seaplane has taken off and we are currently 7,000 feet above sea level. The flight is interestingly being flown by the first ever female seaplane pilot, Captain Priyanka, right here. And the seaplane can currently hold up to 9 people, a family of 9, and can withstand the weight of 550 kgs. We'll be reaching our destination, which is Mula Dam near Shirdi, in just a couple of minutes.
Introducing the service to Mula Dam with one flight per day and two flights on Thursday, the fare per person is 5,500 rupees. But Meher, the company that has started this service, plans to reduce the rates as the response picks up.
What we have for Mula Dam right now is 5,499 rupees, one way per seat. Is also inaugural pricing, but I think with this we will sustain for a while because I understand this is slightly on the higher side for as compared to a Pavna Dam pricing. As the number of aircraft go up, I think there will be a definite climb down in the pricing as well.
Meher plans to launch the same service to nearby tourist locations and pilgrimages lacking air connectivity but are situated near important water bodies. Well, we have finally arrived here at Mula Dam. We are right in the middle of the lake and a boat is ready to take us to the shore from the seaplane ride. It has got us here in exactly 45 minutes and we are 70 kilometers away from Shirdi. The plan is to extend the service to other locations like Mahabaleshwar, like Nasik, and it will prove to be very convenient for business travelers, for elderly and for families planning to go on pilgrimages. An affordable rate and a very convenient service to bring Maharashtra closer and make it a smaller place. With cameraman Mangesh Amre, Sakhi Deshpande for Headlines Today.
An Irish scientist who's also a semi-professional guitarist has come out with equations explaining the physics behind playing an instrument. If what he says is true, this could revolutionize the entire music industry, both for instrument makers as well as musicians. Let's have a look.
Meet David Robert Grimes from the prestigious Oxford University. He's part scientist and part musician. Robert's combined his interests to devise what he says are the first equations explaining the physics of guitar playing. His models describe how the pitch of notes is changed using techniques known as string bending.
This is a technique where you manipulate the string and move it perpendicular to the fretboard. So I'll give you an example now. So here's just a note, and then we're going to bend it up.
After carrying out some scientific experiments, Robert found that the individual properties of each string had a big effect on the change in pitch. And that, he says, could help instrument manufacturers.
Definitely for someone who's designing an instrument, it would probably be quite useful. A lot of it's intuitively known already. I mean, guitarists will talk about the action of their guitars and they'll talk about the strings they buy, but that's only half the story. If you want to put numbers on it, if you're designing something, it's useful to go from that kind of principle.
For rock musicians like Tim Ricchino, playing is intuitive.
I'm not thinking about the physics of guitar playing at all. I'm just thinking about what note's coming next, usually.
But he still agrees that Robert's research could help him in his other role as a music teacher. But this isn't his first physics lesson either.
I'm trying to go from here to here. Now, I used to do it like this with one finger, which is actually quite hard, because basically you're trying to bend the string up to that note with one lever, which is that finger. I found out from watching older guitar players that when they bend, they use three fingers, so you've effectively got three levers. So the physics of that is you've got more, I guess, fulcrum behind that to push that up. I can hold that there now for as long as I want.
Robert believes that guitar is a useful tool for physics students because string vibrations can be easily seen, heard, and measured. And who knows, it might just be music to their ears.